Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is mostly about earthquakes, since we've had plenty of them all over the country this past week. So what does it mean? At least I can say that I added some Volcano Tourist tips into this update, since I've been getting many questions about the volcano Askja recently. But let's start with a bigger picture about Iceland. And this was last week's dose of earthquakes, and this is how the last 48 hours look like, or well above the Icelandic abnormal norm. And the statistics say that this will most likely fade out, and it looks so now, but every now and then we know how it goes. And in fact, there are 7 volcanoes getting ready for something here in Iceland. So those are strange times around here. And Iceland is a bit like a ticking time bomb, especially when it comes to the volcano Askja. But I will get back at that later. And starting 2 days trip in the south on the good old Reykjanes Peninsula. And the most likely scenario now looks like a submarine eruption. But we do however know that all we need is one earthquake and we are into something that we didn't see coming. And I have to mention this earthquake swarm especially or by the Hellisheiði power station, the largest geothermal power station in Iceland. And the earthquakes that we see on the map every now and then, they are man-made. It is the wastewater from a power plant that is causing this, since they pump it back into the geothermal reservoir to ensure sustainability. So those earthquakes are just side effects. And those of you who are constantly monitoring earthquakes, you needed to know about this. So let's move to what might just be the biggest news of the week, or Katla volcano. And I have been talking about Katla every now and then, since she tends to send us false alarms. So this volcano hasn't been on the top on my lookout list. And Katla needs to do way better to get my full attention. But she almost did it now, after 4 earthquakes over magnitude 3, or quite strong earthquake swarm actually, that seems to be over now, but we don't know for sure. So let's check the statistics. In 2022, and then we have the last 3 months, the last 30 days, and the last 7 days. 38 earthquakes, and counting. So this is a spike for sure, but we have seen it worse. And I just can't say if this means anything. The earthquakes are at very little depth, but that's nothing new. And the tremor graph is showing that it's nothing going on more than usual. However, since I know that many of you are monitoring this, I'm just reminding you about the monitors in the rivers around. And I'm leaving a link for them. Or where you can see the water level and the water conductivity. So those are good tools to use if Katla keeps on shaking. And you can check out my full video about the nearby village Vík for more. And I'm also leaving a link to a good documentary about Katla. But it's just way too early to be speculating about sightseeing spots around there. And this unrest will most likely just fade out. So let's follow the plate boundaries to the north, making a short stopover on Vatnajökull Glacier, where the volcano Grímsvötn is still rumbling. And Grímsvötn is yet another Icelandic one of a kind volcano. But we have this lake above the caldera, and then we have Glacier above the lake. And underneath, we have fire, or something that reminds me of the worst marriages I know about. And we can see the seismic unrest growing there, so I would not be surprised if we would get some big news from Vatnajökull Glacier soon. It could be a simple eruption, just fire coming up from the ice, then a plume of ash for a while, and it could be over and done with in a matter of days, or we could get something different, something unforeseen. So let's take a look at the next one of a kind volcano, Askja. That might just be the biggest danger that we face in 2023 due to how little we know about it and how explosive this volcano can get. And after the last major eruption there, we got stuck with this lake on the caldera. And the latest thermal images show that the lake is still warming up. And I do have a new video online the full story about this volcano that could so easily become the center of attention in Iceland, like the eruption on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So I'm leaving a link to that video so you can get the full story. And a volcanologist said the other day that Askja could just as well go off in a matter of days, but we should also get ready to wait for 1-2 years more. But looking at the most recent earthquake pattern, they are more widespread than I've seen them before, and it's just extremely hard to see where this is taking us. And I mentioned in a video the other day that I need to go up there to Askja to do some photoshooting, but then I found out that here in the north there are very few private planes around, so it's gonna take me a while longer to get someone to fly me up there. However, there might be a better idea on the way, or the thermal drone that I have almost fully funded, and I will bring it home this month. So it is very tempting to get someone to drive me up there to do a proper thermal flight over the region. But the problem is that it's just so hard or even impossible to go there by car now. But when I will have the drone in my hands, there are other ideas that I'm working on. Like to try to get a ride with the Coast Guard helicopter when I go up there next time. So this thermal drone experiment I'm going into, it is a whole new way to look at our hottest regions. So when this drone will be in my hands, it will not collect dust. And Askja is not a tourist friendly volcano, and we don't want to be around if this next eruption turns explosive. But let's say that it is going to be a tourist friendly eruption in some ways, like if it's going to be a fissure eruption, there will be ways for volcano tourists to see such an event, but it depends on the season and other elements how this will turn out. Like the main road up to Askja volcano, it won't open up until June. And let's say that helicopter tours would be possible. It's a long flight from Reykjavik, so my guess is that such tours would be available from Akureyri or Lake Mývatn, where they have a small airport and a little company that offers sightseeing tours. But if the eruption turns explosive, there will be no flights around the volcano. So, in such case, where would the best sightseeing spot be? This is the main road to Askja, and it's very close by the Askja fissure swarm where we got many eruptions during the 1875 events. So I would not bet on that road. It's most likely the first road that they will close, and we have no clue about what this volcano is up to now. So I took a good look at this, and my conclusion was that I should drive over the river, Glacier River, by highway number 1 that leads us to East Iceland until I get to the junction to a place called Mýrdalsjökull. It is the closest inhabited place to the Askja volcano, or 50 kilometers away. So it is possible to do some sightseeing from there, but we have another road leading us further upstream, all the way to Askja, and there is a company in Mýrdalsjökull that offers tours there. So this place, Mýrdalsjökull, it will be the place to go to or the best possible base station in order to get as good view as possible. So I'm leaving a link that you can check out, but I want you also to know that we are not expecting an eruption in the coming days or the coming weeks. And those of you who watched my long video about Askja might already know that this volcano will probably send us strong signs before things get nasty. So this is nothing like the eruptions we have witnessed the last 2 years. We have to be very careful around this one, and it can be tricky to get the photos that we want. But to make up for that, the photos that we might get from such an event, those will be once in a lifetime photos. Not like the tens of thousands of photos that were shot during the eruption last year and in 2021. So Mýrdalsjökull it is, to start preparing. And warning signs for Askja, they might include the northernmost part of the plate boundaries. And I noticed an earthquake at home last Friday, magnitude 3.7, coming from the seafloor near the island Grímsey. But 100 kilometers away, it was only a small vibration. And this part of the plate boundaries has been highly active for the last 2-3 years especially. And we had a record-breaking number of earthquakes there in 2022. and it doesn't look any better this year. The Tjörnes fracture zone is very much locked, but loaded with enough energy for up to magnitude 7 earthquake. That's what the experts say. And this is not far away from the northernmost part of the 200 km long fissure swarm from Askja. But a rifting episode, I can't say. But it's not unlikely if Askja takes off. So this is how it is here in the north. Never a dull moment. And I had a feeling that I might have to do another update soon. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.